Hi there. Let us take the sixth lecture on liquid state. We, in the last video, we talked about normal colligative properties, all the four, namely relative lowering of vapor pressure, elevation of boiling point, depression of freezing point, and osmotic pressure. The last one was osmotic pressure. Right? Let us take up abnormal colligative properties. Let's see what is the difference between normal and abnormal. In the normal colligative properties, where I introduced you to colligative properties, we took a very selective type of solutes which will not undergo any dissociation or association. For example, glucose, sucrose, urea. They dissolve in their molecular forms. Neither they undergo any ionization like an ionic compound like NaCl or calcium chloride or aluminium sulfate, nor they associate like some organic carboxylic acids which form dimers. You know, due to hydrogen bonding, carboxylic acids, they remain as dimers in aqueous solution. In solution of carboxylic acid in different solvents. So, in such a case, it is called abnormal. Since we were beginning, initiating the chapter on colligative properties, which we know the properties which depend only on the number of particles, not on their nature, their identity. But now, we will see if the solute will produce more number of particles due to ion formation or less number of particles due to dimerization or trimerization association. In that case, how the colligative property, the observed colligative property, can be found out by calculation? How the calculated value will match with the observed colligative properties? So that we will study in this video. Now let me eclipse myself. When solute undergoes dissociation like ionic solids or association, for example, I was talking about carboxylic acids forming dimers. Sometimes aluminium chloride also forms dimer Al2Cl6. Sometimes BeCl2, beryllium chloride also exists as Be2Cl4. So in this solution, 1B2Cl4 does the same role as only BeCl2. Had there been no dimerization, monomer particle BeCl2 would do the same job as the fatty, the bulky B2Cl4. For example, benzoic acid is dimerized to form C6H5COOH2, for example. So the monomer C6H5COOH would do the same job as the very bulky dimer. So the number of particles will be reduced if the solute will undergo dimerization or trimerization or in general association. And if it undergoes dissociation, the number of particles will enhance. If it is sodium chloride, then 1 mole of sodium chloride will produce 2 moles of particles. 1 mole of sodium ion and 1 mole of chloride ion. So in all, 2 moles of particles. In the aqueous solution, nobody will see whether it is a very, very thin sodium ion or a bulky chloride ion, or had there been no dissociation, a full NaCl undissociated molecule, particle, how they are segregated. Each segregated, isolated particle, may it be a molecule, may it be an empirical formula unit like NaCl, or may it be an ion Na plus Cl minus, whatever, will do the same job of lowering the vapor pressure, relative lowering of the vapor pressure, elevation of boiling point, or depression of freezing point, or osmotic pressure. Now, when the observed colligative property, does not match with the calculated value obtained by taking the solute as non-dissociative or non-associative type using its empirical formula, like glucose C6H12O6. Similarly, NaCl is NaCl, not Na plus and Cl minus. So if we calculate taking its empirical formula, then the result that we get is not matching with the actual observed value. So what to do? A factor I called the Banta factor is multiplied in the right hand side, that is with the calculated value, that is with the normal value of normal colligative value, to equalize with the observed value. I will further clarify what I am intending to tell you. Just hold on. Banta factor, let us define what is Banta factor I. It's very important in colligative property. Now you will be very an expert in colligative property. You will handle solutes like glucose, like sucrose, urea, which doesn't produce any ions or doesn't associate. You will also handle NaCl, AlCl3, aluminium sulfate, or some solutes undergoing trimerization altogether. So Banta factor is required only when there is a chance of dissociation of the solute or association. Otherwise, I is equal to 1. I is equal to the number of moles of particles produced from 1 mole of solute, calculated from its empirical formula. For example, NaCl, 58.5 gram of NaCl is 1 mole. That is 1 mole. But actually, if it will be completely dissociated, it will form 2 moles of particles. 2 moles of particles, 1 mole of sodium ion, 1 mole of chloride ion. So I is equal to 2 for sodium chloride if it is completely dissociated. Similarly, if it is calcium chloride, 1 mole of calcium chloride will produce 1 mole of calcium ion and 2 moles of chloride ion. So altogether, the number of moles of particles is 3. So the Banta factor is 3 for calcium chloride. Similarly, for aluminium chloride, it is 4. For aluminium sulfate, it is 5. We have presumed that the solute undergoes complete dissociation. No solute will remain in the undissociated form. In that case, we have to make a fresh calculation as to how many moles of undissociated solute particles are left out and how many moles of ionized particles are there. You have to make a calculation. We'll be doing that later. Therefore, observed colligative property, that is in the left side, that we can experimentally measure, delta TB, delta TF, pi, P0 minus PS by P0, these are experimentally determined. And this is normal colligative property that we calculate taking the empirical formula, mass, NaCl, CaCl2, AlCl3, not the average mass of Na plus ion and chloride ion, not the average mass of 1 calcium ion and 2 chloride ions, and so on and so forth. Taking calcium chloride. Similarly, if it is dimerized, you are only taking benzoic acid molecular mass, not its whole 2. So this is the normal colligative property, presuming that it is not undergoing any dissociation or association. And the factor that you have to multiply with the normal colligative property, that is called the Banta factor. It may be 2 for sodium chloride, 3 for calcium chloride, 4 for aluminium chloride, and half for benzoic acid, which will undergo dimerization. If all of the benzoic acid will undergo dimerization, then 1 mole will produce half mole of dimers. So here the Banta factor will be half. So we shall be taking up these two cases, dissociation and association, separately. So what I is equal to, if this is equal to this into this, so I is equal to observed colligative property divided by normal colligative property. This is another definition of I. I will be giving you three definitions. One is the fundamental definition: number of moles of particles produced from 1 mole of solute calculated from its empirical formula. And the other one is the observed colligative property that you measure experimentally by normal colligative property. You calculate basing on its empirical formula. And if you correlate between a colligative property with the molecular mass of the solute, you will find an inverse relationship between any colligative property and the molecular mass of the solute. Therefore, it will be reversed. I is equal to normal. Here normal is below denominator. Observed is numerator. So it will be just reverse. I is equal to normal molecular mass of the solute. That means empirical formula mass. Normal molecular mass means it is normal molecular mass means empirical formula mass. This is nothing but the empirical formula mass. This is nothing but empirical formula mass. Empirical formula mass. Like sodium chloride, it is 58.5. Benzoic acid, you calculate from the formula C6H5COOH and so on. Right? And divided by the abnormal molecular mass of the solute. Abnormal means, you know, it will come if you, supposing you do not know what is I, supposing you are not told what is I, but you took sodium chloride normal molecular mass as 58.5, and when you calculate in any colligative property out of the four, you get the molecular mass of sodium chloride, say it is nearly half of it. So 58.5, it comes to be 29 or around that. So you will be astonished how, and you know the solute is sodium chloride, its molecular mass, you know, it's 58.5, but in the calculation, supposing you take up this delta TB is equal to, you don't put any I, you do not know what is I, you are told sodium chloride. You do not know, you are a beginner, you do not know what is I. You say KB into molality. While calculating molality, you take, you know, number of moles of solute by mass of the solvent in gram into 1000 is the molality. You find out as in N2, you have mass of the solute by molecular mass of the solute. When you calculate this M2, will be the abnormal molecular mass. You can call it observed molecular mass or abnormal molecular mass, which will be undoubtedly coming less than the normal, because we know for certain that I is greater than 1 for dissociative type of solute. It will be definitely greater than 1. 1 mole will produce definitely more than 1 mole of particles. Taking positive and negative ions together, the number of moles of particles produced from 1 mole of an ionic solid will be more than 1, so definitely the abnormal. Then you can find out what is I. Supposing you have not used I here, and you have just treated as a normal colligative property, and the only unknown in the calculation is the molecular mass. This number of moles is mass of the solute by molecular mass of the solute. What you get will surprise you, that it will be not same as its empirical formula mass. That ratio will give you I. Once you know I, you can know everything, you know, what it is, degree of dissociation, all other things you can know, right? So there are many ways to handle the problem. We will be doing a lot of problems in this particular case. Since colligative property is inversely proportional to the molecular mass of the solute, all the four colligative properties, you have to find either molality or molarity. Or mole fraction. In all of them, you have to have mass of the solute divided by molecular mass of the solute. So colligative property is inversely proportional to molecular mass of the solute. Therefore, it is reversed. I is equal to observed colligative property by normal colligative property, or normal molecular mass by abnormal molecular mass. Normal colligative property is calculated by taking the empirical formula mass, that is normal molecular mass. For example, if it is sodium chloride, it's 58.5, not the average of the two ions. If it is benzoic acid, simply this 122, not its double, You are using the empirical formula while you are getting a normal colligative property here, this one, right? And this is the experimental value. So that ratio will give you I, right? Now, here, the real situation has come. Where I is equal to 1, we have been discussing non-dissociative type of solute, where non-associative type of solute, where I is equal to 1. So we were not talking about I. But here, I is different from 1, is greater than 1 for dissociative type of solute, and less than 1 for associative type of solute. So you have to now, taking all of them into account, you have to multiply I here. Of course, in this case, you have to also multiply I here in the numerator, as well as because when you find the mole fraction, you also have to add up the number of moles of solvent with the number of moles of solute. Since the number of moles of solute has changed to I times, therefore this In2 should also be there, which I missed out for actual calculation. This I must be here. And similarly, I into KB into molality, I into KF into molality, I into MRT. This is M is molarity, R is the gas constant, T is the absolute temperature for osmotic pressure. So let us take up case 1, where solutes undergoing dissociation. We have already discussed that ionic solids produce more ions, more particles than their molecular formula units. Supposing you take 1 mole of sodium chloride, if it is completely dissociated, then it will produce 2 moles of particles. If I is equal to 1, then it is the case of non-dissociative or non-associative type of solute, like glucose, urea, sucrose, which we have already done. We have mastered over them. But now, for case of dissociation, I has to be greater than 1 for solutes undergoing dissociation. For example, for complete dissociation, I is equal to 2 for sodium chloride, because 1 mole of sodium chloride will produce 2 moles of particles. Similarly, for it is calcium chloride, it is 3. For aluminium chloride, I is 4, because 1 mole will produce 4 moles of particles. 1 mole of aluminium, 3 moles of chloride ions. If it is aluminium sulfate, 3 plus 2, 5, and so on. But since the degree of dissociation is not always equal to 1, is not 100% dissociated or 100% associated, there must be some molecules which will remain undissociated, like NaCl as such, going together as a form of a compact molecular empirical formula unit, not molecular empirical formula unit. So that will be counted as 1 particle. And Na plus, which are separated, ionized completely, it will be counted as 1 particle, chloride ion 1 particle, and the undissociated NaCl as 1 particle. So since the degree of dissociation is not always 1, it is to be found out what is a real value of I, taking into account the degree of dissociation not equal to 1. Let's find that. Now, I will ask you a oral level question, a verbal level question, right? You tell me, look at me. Supposing you are given 1 mole of sodium chloride and it will tell you that the degree of dissociation is 0.8. 80% of sodium chloride is dissociated. Remaining 20% remain in the undissociated form. So in that case, what is the factor I? What is the number of moles of particles that are formed in that case from 1 mole of the empirical formula unit? I give you few seconds. You can pause this video and think. 1 mole of sodium chloride, if the degree of dissociation is 0.8, what will be I? What? Is it 1.6 or 1.8? 1.8. Why? Because if point out of 1 mole, if 0.8 mole will go, it will produce 0.8 mole of sodium ion and 0.8 mole of chloride ion. So 0.8 plus 0.8 is 1.6. But what will be the left out NaCl formula units which are not dissociated? They will also produce a colligative property. So that is 0.2. 1 minus 0.8 is 0.2. So 0.2 is the undissociated NaCl, 0.8 Na plus ion, 0.8 Cl minus ion. So if you add all these, it will be 1.8. So the maximum value of I is equal to 2 for sodium chloride. That is the number of ions produced from one formula unit of that compound. That is the maximum value of I. But I can be less than that. But it has to be greater than 1. It has to be greater than 1 because it is an ionic solute. There will be some degree of dissociation, however small it may be. It may be 10%, 20%, whatever. But the number of moles of particles will be definitely greater than 1 out of 1 mole of empirical formula unit. Let us now calculate a formula. Let us make a handy formula to find out this I. Supposing you have a reactant molecule undergoing dissociation giving n particles. I am including both positive ion and negative ion as X, because in colligative property nobody distinguishes between sodium ion and chloride ion, calcium ion. So all of them are doing the same job. So let's say one empirical formula unit produces n number of particles. For example, sodium chloride, 2. N is equal to 2. 1 sodium ion and 1 chloride ion. If it is calcium chloride, the one formula unit will produce 3. 1 calcium ion and 2 chloride ion. So X represents all. And the number of particles, ions, in fact, in case of dissociation, it is ions, is n. Total number of particles produced, ions produced from one empirical formula unit is n. Supposing the initial number of mole is 1 and it is 0, at equilibrium, if alpha is the degree of dissociation, then it will produce n alpha. 1, 0. If formula unit produce n particles, if alpha moles will go, it will produce n times alpha, n alpha, and the remaining number of moles of the undissociated A is 1 minus alpha. Let us add these two, this small particles and this undissociated particle. So if you add these two, that is nothing but I. Because what is the definition of I? The first definition I gave you, it is the number of moles of particles, both dissociated and undissociated, produced from one mole of the solute, empirical formula unit of solute. Now, when you add it, take alpha as common, you get n minus 1. So this is the very, very famous formula that you have to remember, that I is equal to 1 plus alpha into n minus 1. So what is alpha? It's the degree of dissociation. And what is n? N is the number of ions, particles, produced from one formula unit of the ionic solute. So this is the main formula, I is equal to 1 plus alpha into n minus 1. And from that, you can have another formula. Alpha is equal to degree of dissociation is equal to I minus 1 divided by n minus 1. I suggest not to remember this formula. This formula only will help you for everything. For getting alpha, for getting I, whatever, for getting n, whatever. I is the Van 't Hoff factor. That is the number of times the normal colligative property has to be multiplied so that it matches with the observed value. Clear? Now we go to the dissociative type of solute. Associative type of solute. Some solutes undergo polymerization, say dimerization, trimerization, to form bigger size particles. In such case, the number of particles become less than their formula units. For example, benzoic acid undergoes dimerization to form a dimer. Then one mole of such benzoic acid will form 0.5 mole of dimer particles. If the degree of association is 100%, 1, or the percentage of association is 100%, in that case, one mole will exactly form 0.5 mole of dimer particles. So the I value will be 0.5 in this case. So I is always less than 1 for solutes undergoing association, right? If it is forming a trimer, 3, then it will be 1 by 3. 1 mole will be reduced to 1 by 3.33333. If 4 molecules tetramerize, then it is 1 by 4. That is 0.25 will be the value of I, provided 100% of the molecules undergo polymerization, right? But let us try to find out a similar type of formula. If alpha here, there alpha was degree of dissociation, but here alpha is the degree of alpha. I'm not able to write here. There is some technical problem for which possibly I cannot write. Yes. Okay. Then I think I shall do something to retrieve my pen tablet, since it is this is going on. Since this PPT PowerPoint was going on, it's had some problem. So I will definitely try to bring it again and see if I can retrieve my pen. Otherwise, we have to do a large number of numericals. Let's see. Yes. Thanks God. Now, in case of association, for example, n small molecules, n number of small molecules unite, associate to form one big molecule. This is one, an. N is the subscript. So for example, in case of benzoic acid, I told you n is equal to 2. 2 benzoic acid molecules unite to form a dimer. So if you take initially one mole, and at equilibrium, supposing alpha is the degree of association, alpha, I have not written alpha, is the degree of association. If you are following me as a beginner, then I will suggest you to intermittently pause the video and write. Because I have not given a reference file for that now at this moment. Degree of association is alpha in this case. So if alpha is the degree of association, then 1 minus alpha is the remaining unassociated solute, and alpha by n is the number of moles of the polymer particle. This is the polymer particle, dimer, trimer, tetramer, in general polymer particle. So if alpha mole goes, then it will produce alpha by n moles of the big particles. So if you add these two, 1 minus alpha is the remaining unassociated monomers, and alpha by n is the big particles. So if you add these two and take alpha common, then this is the handy equation you will be using for association. I is equal to 1 plus alpha into 1 by n minus 1. That is the only difference, you just remember. Here it is n minus 1, and here it is 1 by n minus 1. This is not required. Once you remember this formula, then this alpha is equal to I minus 1 divided by 1 by n minus 1. That will be spontaneous, right? But the difference here is alpha is the degree of association. There it was degree of dissociation. And here n is the number of small molecules, small solute molecules undergoing association. Number of solute molecules represented by its empirical formula. Empirical formula units undergoing association. In case of dimer, n is equal to 2. In case of tetramer, it is 4, and so on. So let us solve some problems. I would like you to solve some problems. Just a second, please. I have a ready-made answer with me. So it will help you to save time. You read this question, calculate the freezing point of a solution. Let me see how long we can continue. It is 30 minutes. I think we can continue. Calculate the freezing point of a solution obtained by mixing 5 gram of calcium chloride in 100 gram water. Presume calcium chloride to be 80% dissociated. 80% dissociated. Kf, the molal freezing constant is of water is 1.86 Kelvin kg mole inverse, right? So here we know delta Tf is equal to I. Now I is a factor. Always I is a factor for simpler molecules with solutes which do not undergo dissociation or association. I is equal to 1. I into Kf into molality. That is the equation. Now delta Tf we have to find out first. So first let us find out what is I. I is equal to 1 plus alpha into n minus 1. You remember just now for dissociation this is our handy formula. You have to be very very conversant with this formula. I is equal to 1 plus alpha into n minus 1. So calcium chloride, tell me what is the value of n. One formula unit produces how many particles? It's 3. One positive ion, 2 negative ions. So n is equal to 3 here. So n is equal to 3 here. And alpha is 80% means alpha is 0.8. Percentage is 80% means degree is 0.8. So let us write down 1 plus 0.8 into n is equal to 3 minus 1. So it is 1.6 plus 1, 2.6. So 2.6 is the value of I, the Van 't Hoff factor. Right? So then we have to use this formula. Delta Tf is equal to 2.6 I into Kf is 1.86 into molality. What is molality? It is the number of moles of solute per kg of the solvent. So mass of the solute is 5 and the molecular mass of calcium chloride, if you add 40 plus 71, it will be 111. So this is the number of moles of solute by mass of the solvent in gram into 1000. That is the molality. So by calculation, I have the ready-made answer with me. I got the value delta Tf, the depression in freezing point, I got, it is a 2.178. So if the depression is this much, then what is the freezing point of the solution? Definitely it is 0, because the freezing point of pure water is 0 degree Celsius. And it will be lowered. The freezing point is always depressed or lowered. So it will 0 minus this depression, 2.178, that is equal to minus 2.178 degree Celsius. Or if you are asked to submit in Kelvin, then Tf is equal to 273 minus 2.178 is equal to maybe 8.22. Yes, it is in Kelvin. This is in Kelvin. So depending on in which unit the question demands, in this question I have not told you any unit, Kelvin or Celsius. It is your prerogative. So we have done in both. Let's go to the next question. I hope you understood. Did you? Good. What is the vapor pressure of a solution containing 0.05 moles of the solute K2SO4, it is again dissociative, in 100 gram water at 300 Kelvin? Degree of dissociation, degree of. I'm so sorry. Degree of dissociation. Degree of dissociation at this concentration, again 80%, I mean 0.8. The vapor pressure of pure water at 300 Kelvin is 31.834 millimeter of mercury. So this is relative lowering of vapor pressure, and the formula is like this. The formula that we use here, as you know, is the Raoult's law, P0 minus PS by P0 is equal to I Van't Hoff factor. Now comes into the mole fraction of the solute N2 by total number of moles of solute and solvent N1 plus I into N2, because if in the numerator it is I times N2, in the denominator also the number of moles of solute particles has to be added to N1, the number of moles of solvent. So let us find out first what is I in this problem. I is, you know, 1 plus alpha into N minus 1. And here also N is equal to 3. Potassium sulfate produces 2 potassium ions and 1 sulfate ion. So the number of particles is 3. So N is equal to 3 here, and alpha is given 0.8. Degree of dissociation is 0.8, like the previous problem. So again we get the same value of I, because alpha is 0.8 and N is 3 like the previous one, so we get 2.6. And if you put the values, P0, the vapor pressure of pure water, is 31.834 minus PS, that we are going to find, PS, the vapor pressure of the solution, divided by 31.834. That is equal to I is 2.6 into N2 is given directly. You can use 0.05, divided by N1, 100 grams of water is how many moles? 100 by 18 is 5.555 recurring. Plus I is 2.6 into 0.05. You cannot neglect this. You could have neglected 0.05 had there been no I, but here 2.6 into 0.05 will be quite appreciable. So do not have the bad habit of neglecting always N2 in the denominator. So if you keep everything, you get a correct answer. Most correct answer, I into N2. And on calculation, we found that the vapor pressure of the solution is 31.106 millimeter of mercury. Right? So there has been a reduction in the vapor pressure. Pure solvent is 31.834 and the solution is 31.106. There has been a detectable decrease in the vapor pressure of the solution vis-a-vis the solvent, pure solvent. 0.5% W by W, mass by mass, percent of aqueous solution of KCl freezes at minus 0.24 degree Celsius. Calculate the degree of dissociation. And KF value of water, it is already told before, 1.86 kg mole inverse. Right? So, this time it is not given the molality. You have to find the molality. This is the percent strength by mass. And the depression can be easily found out. If the aqueous solution of KCl has a freezing point equal to this much, then what is the depression? What is the difference? 0 minus minus 0.24. It is nothing, but this is creating a problem. What to do? I left it in a wilderness, in a desert. Let's see if it is creating problem. So the change is again this thing, because the freezing point of pure water is zero and the freezing point of the solution is minus 0.24, so the difference is only 0.24. So delta Tf is equal to I into Kf into molality. So let us find out what is I. Here we have to find I. I is unknown. We have to calculate what is the van 't Hoff factor. Delta Tf is given 0.24 is equal to I into Kf is 1.86. Molality we can find out 0.5 gram of solute present in 100 gram of solution. So 0.5 gram divided by the molecular mass, the empirical formula mass of KCl is 74.5. 39 plus 35.5. yes, so 0.5 divided by 74.5, this is the number of moles of solute, divided by the mass of the solvent. Out of 100 gram, if 0.5 gram is the solute, so 95.5 gram is the mass of the pure solvent into 1000. So that is the molality. And from the calculation we got, I is equal to 1.91 is I, van 't Hoff factor. Has to be greater than 1. Maximum value is 2, because n is 2. The maximum value of I is equal to n, 2. But it is less than that because it is not 100% dissociated. We have to find out what is that degree of dissociation. You know the formula. I is equal to 1 plus alpha into n minus 1. N is equal to 2 here, 2 particles. So which means alpha is equal to I minus 1 by n minus 1. That is equal to 1.91 minus 1 by 2 minus 1. So that is nothing but 0.91. So in this solution, potassium chloride is 91% dissociated. Remaining 9% is undissociated. Got it? Now let us go to the last sum, where we will handle a problem or numerical on association. We're talking so much about it. 2 gram of benzoic acid was dissolved in 25 gram of benzene. Here benzene is the solvent, not water, which showed a depression of freezing point by or of 1.62 Kelvin. So that is delta T is directly given. It shows a depression of freezing point by, it should be by 1.62 Kelvin. So delta Tf is directly given 1.62. So the difference is same in Celsius as well as in Kelvin. Although the absolute values are different, but the differences are same. Calculate the degree of association, alpha. In case of association, alpha is the degree of association. Presuming the acid undergoes dimerization. So N is equal to 2, it is already given. That means two molecules of C6H5COOH will give you C6H5COOH whole 2. So we need not have to go for a breakup. We already know the formula, the ready-made formula that we will be using that for solving problem. Now delta Tf is given, Kf is given. For benzene, Kf is 4.9 kg mole inverse. For water it is 1.86, but for benzene it is 4.9 kg mole inverse, and delta Tf is given. So delta Tf is equal to I into Kf into molality. So you have to find out I. In this case also I is unknown, you have to find out. So 1.62 is equal to I into 4.9 is the Kf value into molality. Let us find out 2 gram of benzoic acid, 2 divided by, you have to take the empirical formula mass, because the normal colligative property is the right side, which makes use of the empirical formula mass, not the dimer, not the trimer, not the ion, nothing. So empirical formula of benzoic acid is is this. So it is how much we have to find out the molecular mass of benzoic acid is 122. You calculate the molecular mass of benzoic acid C6H5COOH will be equal to 122. So 2 gram of benzoic acid by the molecular mass is 122. This is the number of moles of solute by mass of the solvent is 25 into 1000. This is the molality. So here we found the Van 't Hoff factor must be less than 1. You know this is association. The value of I that we got is 0.504. Very close to 0.5. So if I is equal to 0.504, we know the handy formula. I is equal to 1 plus alpha into 1 by n minus 1. This is the only difference. Where n is equal to 2, it is dimerization. So from here, alpha is equal to I minus 1 by 1 by n minus 1. Right? So if you put the value I is equal to 0.504 minus 1, this is the numerator is minus and the denominator is also minus. 1 by 2 minus 1. So the answer is coming 0.992. That means that benzoic acid is nearly 100% associated. 99.2% benzoic acid is associated. Only 0.008%, 0.8% is not associated. It is remaining as monomers. Right? So, because I was coming almost close to 0.5, so from there we had a suspicion that the degree of association will be nearly 100%. The percentage of association will be nearly 100%. Right? Now, this question is for you. Here, this is an osmotic pressure. Now, let us do it. Why? Not leave. A decimolar, this is a problem on osmotic pressure, abnormal colligative property. We have not yet handled any problem on osmotic pressure involving I. A decimolar M by 10 solution of potassium ferrocyanide is 50% as a dissociated, again dissociation, at 300 Kelvin. Calculate its osmotic pressure. So pi is equal to I into R into M into T. R is the gas constant, M is the molarity, T is the absolute temperature. So I, we have to find out. I is equal to 1 plus alpha, it is dissociation, N minus 1. And we know potassium ferrocyanide, the value of N is equal to 5. It gives 4 potassium ion and a very fatty, bulky, obese ferrocyanide ion, which will do the same job as one single potassium ion. Such is the bad luck of the bulky person who cannot fight as more stronger than K plus. So 4 plus 1, 5. So N is equal to 5 in this case. So 1 plus alpha is 50.5. It is 50% dissociated. That is, it is 0.5 into 5 minus 1. So that comes as exactly 3. This is 4.5 is 2, 2 plus 1, 3. So I is 3 here. And so pi is equal to 3 into 0.082 liter atmosphere per Kelvin per mole is the universal gas constant. And the molarity is directly given decimolar. That is 1 by 10 or 0.1. Decimolar means 0.1 into temperature is 300. So pi is coming 7.389 atmosphere. You have to place the unit. Without a unit, you will be getting no mark, no credit at all. So since it is 0.082 atmosphere Kelvin atmosphere. In terms of atmosphere, liter atmosphere per Kelvin per mole, and this molarity is in moles per liter, so everything gets cancelled, we get atmosphere. So the osmotic pressure of such a solution having I is equal to 3 is as high as 7.389. So there is another problem which is very simple, involving boiling point elevation. You can do that. Now here is a tricky question, a thought-provoking question. I think it is 50 minutes. We can spend 5 minutes more to solve this tricky question. Arrange in the order of increasing boiling points and freezing points separately for these solutions. 0.1 m sucrose, 0.1 m urea, 0.1 m sodium chloride, 0.1 m aluminium chloride. These two undoubtedly normal, I is equal to 1, and these two I is not equal to 1. Here I is equal to 2, I is equal to 4 here, right? Whenever you encounter such a question, when degree of dissociation is not given, let me face you, when the degree of dissociation is not given, you presume that the degree of dissociation is 1. It is 100% dissociated. Usually in dilute solution, an ionic compound is nearly 100% dissociated. So in such a question, you presume that I value is equal to N. So here it is 2, here it is 4. Now, when you solve this problem, you presume that molarity and molality, they are nearly same. For dilute solution, molarity and molality, they are nearly same. So when the molality is same, only I factor matters. So when you know delta TB, the elevation in boiling point is equal to I into KB into molality. Since KB is fixed, it is aqueous solution. Molality is fixed because all are 0.1 m. The only factor which determines delta B, delta TB, is I. More is the I, more is the delta TB, and hence more is the boiling point, because boiling point is elevated. Now this is 1, this is 1, this is 2, this is 2, I factor. So unfortunately these two are identical. So the decreasing order, this is increasing order, so we have to write the answer. So far as boiling point is concerned, it is bit 1 is equal to bit 2 because the I factor is same, 1-1 on dissociative type of solute, and the molarity or molality is same. So their colligative properties, delta TB same, so the actual boiling point also same. That is less than this 2, because I is 2 here. The, oh, this is 3 and 4, I am so sorry. It could be, it should be, I am so sorry. Let me see, yes, this is 3 and this is 4. It's okay. So the order is like this, 1 is equal to 2, less than 3, less than 4. But so far as freezing point is concerned, it will be just the opposite, because more is the delta TF, less is the actual freezing point. Molality is same, KF is water, same. I, more is the I, more is the delta TF. So 0 minus that. So the actual numerical value is lower. If delta TF is numerically more, then minus 4, minus 7. So minus 7 is lower than minus 4. So more is the delta TF, less is the freezing point. So the minimum freezing point will be that of this one. So when you go for an increasing order, so this 4 is less than 3, is less than 2, which is equal to 1. You understood? So for freezing point and boiling point, the actual values of freezing point and boiling point is in the opposite order. Freezing point is depressed, lowered, but boiling point is elevated. Similarly, there is another type of interesting problem, thought-provoking question. Here it is percentage. Supposing this is W by V. If nothing is given, you will take it as volume percent, W by V percent. All are same volume percent, 0.5%, 0.5 gram of solute present in 100 ml solution, right? Here, this is not molality, it's not the number of moles, it is the mass, 0.5 gram. So here you have to consider another factor. in addition to I, you know, freezing point and boiling point, supposing you take delta TB is equal to I into KB into molality. If for molality, you have to go for mass of the solute by molecular mass of the solute. Mass is fixed, 0.5 for all, but molecular masses are different. Glucose, urea, sodium chloride, and all are different. This empirical formula mass you have to take, all are different. So delta TB or delta TF is directly proportional to I and all inversely proportional to molecular mass of the solute. So you have to take a joint effect, calculate. So for beat one, it is what? I is equal to 1 divided by molecular mass is glucose is 180. For 2, it is again I is equal to 1 by molecular mass of urea, I think it is 60. Urea is NH2, CONH2. You calculate, I think it is 60. And for 3, it is sodium chloride, it is 2. But the Bantoff factor is 2 here. You have to consider 100% dissociation if such a question you face by 58.5. And 4, it is Hughes. The Bantoff factor is 5. 4 plus 1, 5 divided by, and the molecular mass is Hughes. I don't have a Hughes. I don't have time to calculate. So the one having the minimum value out of all these 4 will have the minimum boiling point, because boiling point is directly proportional to delta TB, but the freezing point is inversely because it is minus. So you calculate all these, take the molecular mass of potassium ferrocyanide, find the values, and the minimum is the value, minimum is the boiling point, and it goes on increasing. But freezing point, minimum is the value, maximum is the freezing point. Maximum is the value of delta TF, minimum is the boiling point. So accordingly, you answer this question and discuss with your friends. So with this, I conclude this session. And if you have come up to this point, you have viewed and very seriously watched with a pen and paper, done everything, then put a comment in the comment box below. And also, if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please do so. You will not lose anything if legitimately, if you like a channel and you subscribe, simply you gain all the successive videos will be communicated to you. You may view it or not. And that will also help the video creator to have some limelight in the YouTube. Bye-bye.